So my first year of uni is officially over. In this video, I will cover all of these study tips that I wish I knew before starting, and hopefully they'll help you even before you start. If you're new to this channel, welcome. My name is Jane. I am a biology major at McGill University. Feel free to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, and leave me a comment down below letting me know what you'll be studying at uni. The first most important thing you need to know is that you need to be on top of your shit. Uni is all about independence. From day one, your teachers will give you a course syllabus. Read it as soon as possible. You'll get an idea of what the course is about, the scope of the course, the weights of the assignments and exams. If you read it soon enough, you'll be able to decide whether or not you want to stay in the course or if you want to drop it and switch for another course. You need to mark down all important due dates in your calendar, your planner, homework app, whatever it is you use. Profs will typically remind you of anything that is due only one class ahead of time, if they remind you at all. So if you want to have time to study and to learn the material thoroughly, you will have to keep track of all of your due dates. The second study tip that I have is to use the calendar app. It's pre-installed on all Apple devices, so it comes free. So when I was in my first year of uni, what I used was a combination of my homework app and my digital planner on my iPad. I'll put a link here to the video where I explain how I use my iPad to plan if you guys are interested. So with the calendar app, if I knew about it, this is how I would use it. First, I would block in my course schedule. So for each course, I would add in the tutorial, the lecture, study groups, anything like that. You block it in and you repeat that for each week that you have school. And then from there, I would add in study blocks. So for each lecture that you have of the week, you should have a corresponding study block. And I'll go into more detail later on in the video, but this is because it'll help you keep up with the material so you don't cram everything right before the exam. The third thing I'm gonna talk about is attendance. So every other video on YouTube will probably tell you that attendance is necessary. I'm gonna say otherwise. It really just depends on the type of person you are. If the lecture is recorded, then you might or might not have to attend the lecture. If it's not recorded though, please go attend the lecture if you want that 4.0 GPA. So in my case, I live off campus and it takes me an hour and a half to travel to and from school. Most days, I only have two classes of 1 hour each, which means I'm traveling an hour and a half to attend 2 hours worth of lectures. If you think about it, that's not really the best use of my time, but I still attended lectures because I know myself and I know that if I don't go to school, I probably won't watch the lecture recordings right as they're uploaded, so then I'll fall behind in school material. However, if you know that you are someone that has enough self-discipline and will watch the lecture recordings as they get posted, by all means, stay home. You're saving yourself commute time, you're saving yourself time in general, because you can watch the lecture recordings at twice the recorded speed. Everything in uni is about efficiency and saving time. It really depends on what type of person you are. Choose what is right for you. The fourth tip would be how to take notes during lectures. What I did throughout my first year was I would download the slides and then annotate them in class as the professor spoke. But I did notice that most people were typing everything on their laptop. When I saw that, I was kind of like, how does that make sense? Because it's kind of redundant to just transcribe the PowerPoint slides onto a new document and then just to add in what the professor is saying. But if everyone's doing it, they're doing it for a reason. So what I would do that was inefficient was I would go to lectures, listen to the professor speak, learn the material a bit, annotate the slides, go home, completely forget what I learned, reread the lecture slides, and then create my own notes. If you had been typing up your notes during class, you would skip over this whole process and you wouldn't have to reread the lecture slides, relearn the material, and then make your own notes. It's a really effective method to be using in uni, especially since there is a lot of material that has to be covered. I don't know if this can apply to every single program. I'm sure for engineers, there's a lot of formulas involved, so I don't know if typing on the computer would be the most efficient way to take notes, but this applies for most health-related courses. I also don't recommend taking notes by hand on a piece of paper. I have only seen a handful of people do this. If no one's doing it, there's probably a reason. You don't have the slides with you, so you have to keep track of which notes go with which slides. If you lose track, you're gonna have to go home and then match them up one by one. So it's even more inefficient than the iPad method. But this might not be true for everyone. I'm sure everyone has their preferences and what works best for them. This is what I discovered and this is what I personally think will work best. The fifth thing I'm gonna talk about are study guides. I recently found out about them and I think they are so useful. From what I understand, a study guide is basically just a condensed form of all of your separate lecture notes combined into one big chapter. If you have been taking notes on your computer throughout the semester, then all you really have to do is just add in some information from your readings and your textbook into your Word document or your OneNote, and then come time for the exam, read over your notes for each lecture, highlight only what is most relevant and testable material, and then literally copy paste that into a new document titled study guide. I think this is really important because when we take notes, we're typically writing down everything, like the context, the background, but once you really learn the material, you typically don't study everything that is in your notes, right? So the study guide will just compact all your notes. It only contains the most relevant information. Anyone who gives you tips on how to study in uni will say that you have to go over the material, and I'm gonna reinforce this point. Most of the work in uni is done outside the classroom. So I procrastinated pretty badly throughout the semesters. Don't do that. I went to bed at like 4 a.m. during exam time. I skipped classes. I'm telling you, it's a really, really bad idea. The least you can do is go over what you've learned 24 to 48 hours after the lecture. Apparently that's the sweet spot. You should be making notes if you didn't already make notes during the lecture. That way, when you have to study for your exam, all you have to do is print out your notes for each lecture or create a study guide and then study off of those. My mistake was that I never made notes for the classes after class. I would kind of just go over the material, but obviously I'm not going to remember that material 2 months later when it's exam time. So then I would still have to go back and then relearn the lectures and then make notes, but it's a really inefficient method, so just make notes after each class. The seventh thing I'm going to talk about is readings and textbooks. All profs are going to tell you that their readings and their textbooks are required and you need to read them in order to get an A in their class. Let me just tell you right now, I have gotten A's in classes where professors have told me the same thing and I didn't do a single reading. Over time, you will learn to distinguish between the important and the unimportant readings like I did. Let's just think about it for a moment. If, let's say, on a Tuesday night, you're doing readings for Wednesday's class, well then when are you supposed to review your Monday's lectures? You're never gonna have time to review the lectures and do the readings. Lectures are your priority. That's the main testable material. The readings help reinforce what you've learned, give you context, and so reviewing the lectures is the most important. After you've reviewed all your Monday's lectures, if you have time, you can do some readings for Wednesday's class. So a tip that I have that I did was I would download the readings and I would control find keywords only for topics that I didn't understand. So rather than reading a 40-page reading, I would only have to read certain paragraphs that pertain to the topic I was searching for. Also, I just want to note, for all the professors that told me this reading will be on the exam, you should do it, I've never ever encountered an exam where a question had nothing to do with the lecture and everything to do with the reading. The eighth point is all about learning. The reason why uni is so tough is because you're not memorizing everything and then regurgitating it on an exam. The professor's exams or the course coordinator's exams are designed to measure whether or not a student truly understands the material. So I hate to break it to you, but whatever worked for you in high school or stage up, where you would just skim over the material before an exam and then ace it, that is not gonna happen in uni. The ninth thing I'm gonna talk about is resources. The professors and the TAs are truly there to help you. No matter what the failing average is, I promise they are there to help. There are tutorials, office hours, study groups. There are so many resources that you can turn to in case you ever don't understand a topic or if you are confused about material. You're paying such an expensive tuition, you're paying for all of these resources as well. So don't be shy to go to that study group and be like, hey, can you explain this to me because I really didn't understand. It will help you stay on top of your material. They will most likely cover the most recent lecture topics. So if you haven't been keeping up, you won't understand what's going on in the tutorial. So it'll force you to stay on top of your material. The last thing I'm gonna talk about are grades. I'm not gonna tell you how to get that 4.0 GPA because I honestly don't even have a 4.0 GPA, but this is also really helpful information about your grades. If you've been studying, keeping up with the material, and truly understanding the material, but somehow during the exam, the question's too difficult, the exam is too long, you don't know this topic, you're most probably not the only one. Don't ask me why professors choose to make their exams extremely difficult just to curve the grade up, because I have no idea. If the class average is a really, really low grade, the professors will most likely curve it up to bring it up to a certain grade. I'm gonna take my cell biology and metabolism class as an example. So for our first midterm, I think the class average was somewhere in the 50s or the 60s. My professor told us he will be curving the grades up by 10 to 15%. Guys, do you know how much that is? So at McGill, I've learned that there is a standard class average that profs will try to meet. I don't know if this applies to all of McGill or just the science department, but the class average that they try to meet is 75%. But this also won't help you every single time. For example, in my organic chemistry class, our first midterm was extremely easy. The class average was like 85. I don't think they would ever curve grades down because that's just a little harsh, but they would make the next exams more difficult just to balance out the grades. If one of those 10 tips was remotely helpful, please give this video a big thumbs up and show your girl some support by subscribing if you haven't already. Leave me in the comments down below any questions that you have regarding McGill or university in general. I will try my best to answer, although I don't have all the answers. As always, thank you guys so much for watching this video and supporting me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!